in spite of tremendous stress on Kundalini by your holiness, it is hard for me to reconcile myself with the fact that there is not the slightest reference of Kundalini in the two eminently authoritative guides on yoga. I mean Patanjali's Yoga Sutra or Gita. Why?
Yes, it's surprising that people will say, he says that in Yoga Sutra of Patanjali, it is not written about Kundalini, and also about Gita, it's not written about Kundalini's fact. Because, you see, it was a secret science. It was kept a secret science. In my first lecture only I said, till the 6th century. In the 6th century, Adi Shankaracharya for the first time opened his mouth about it. It was a secret science with very great gurus like Janaka gave realization to Nachiketa. And in the same way, Sri Krishna did not talk about it. Because, you see, even when Markandeya talked about it, people did not know what he was talking. They never thought him to be a sensible man. Then later on, as the people became into two compartments, one on the right, one on the left side, some started worshipping God in a devotion and in a bhakti way, the another started doing yajna, havanadi things. So whatever was required for these two types of things evolved, and that's what we developed. The central side of evolution was kept a secret. And even at the time of Sri Krishna, it was not mentioned. A word about this thing was mentioned. Because this is an internal happening, this is an antar yoga. It was not described, but Sri Krishna hinted at it, that you have to have your yoga. But how, he did not say, because that was not the time. He was the one who laid the seeds. That's why he is called as Krishna. Krishna means Krishi, the one who has done Krishi. So this one was laid, the sprouting had to come. Today it was to be told, so I am telling you about it. Everything is not told at the same time. Same in Sahaja Yoga. We don't tell you everything at this about Agya Chakra. I have told you something, but not all. Gradually, when you will be so aware, I will tell you. It has to be seen how far to be said at what time. And that's what was needed at that time was told by Krishna. So Gita is the one which only tells you that this will happen. But Jnaneshwara, who was born after the 6th century, in Jnaneshwari has written about Kundalini, clearly. Because though Gita it is not written, but he said this is how it is done. Jnaneshwara has written. Though he has written, it's the Gita translated into a common language, he put also the knowledge of Kundalini. Because at that time it was to be told. Before that it was not to be told. Shankaracharya at the 6th century did it, then Jnaneshwara did it, then Nanaka did it, then Kabira did it, all these people did it. Not only, but even Muhammad Sahib in a way has talked about it, about the Sahaja Yoga and resurrection time. They all started talking about the resurrection time much later as they started seeing people getting there. Because to talk too much about the future is dangerous. That time Sri Krishna was placed with Arjuna when they were at the war. At that time he had to talk about the problems of Hinsa, Ahinsa and those ideas which we have, about wrong ideas we have. And that's how he talked on that subject. Whatever was the subject, he talked on that. And he told him how to become one with God. And not how, that when you become one with God, you become a sthita pragna. He gave the idea as to what will happen to you, but how it will happen, he did not say. That was left to me to explain. They can't do everything, I have to do something, isn't it? Because if he had said how, then they would have said, give me realization. But they were not prepared for realization.